This is our platform to introduce business leaders, entrepreneurs, and change makers to our great network of people. And today, to kick things off, I'm interviewing my two partners and executive team members, Erik Wenstone, COO, and Travis Pearson, CEO. Thank you. Maybe to start things off, Travis, you could kind of give me a little bit of background on the genesis and how you started our company.
When I started off CMR, it was truly to create a firm that really provided a value-added service specializing in specific industries. A lot of insurance brokers or just general sales focus a lot on just, hey, what we have to offer, but really we wanted to have a deeper understanding of what our clients did so we could help them with their issues. And in fact, when we first, CMR stood for construction, manufacturing, and real estate, and those were truly the three industries that we had specialized in, which we continue to do. But since then, the company has evolved into other specialties, either from a line of business perspective or from other industries as well. So our first expansion was into employee benefits. We actually had a lot of clients just approach us asking us for that. Given the fact that we, again, we're specialists in specific industries, we never really took that on until we built out a team. And then we expanded into other lines like surety, which is more line of business specific, and then into workers' comp, and then as well into some new other industry practice groups as well.
Okay. And I got to go off script a little bit. Maybe you can talk just about how you started the company. I mean, I think for those of you that don't understand, starting an insurance brokerage is no easy task. So give me a little background, maybe how hard it was and who was there and what you did. I mean, for me, it's an amazing story.
Thanks. It was kind of a little whirlwind. I mean, it was, I worked for an agency that my father was the owner of. And it was not working out. And so at the time decided, okay, hey, should I look to start up a company or should I join another firm? And really my reasons for leaving was, or the issues was, hey, the company wasn't being operated the way I wanted to. So that was kind of the real decision factor. Well, if I go to work for another company, I'm just gonna be under the, you know, operations of whatever someone else wants. And this is an opportunity in my life to try and put into practice how I felt the company should be operated. So really, I started the company, it was just myself and one other account manager, and really, we just grew from there. It was not, we never really set out to have like specific growth goals of, hey, we want X revenue and X number of employees. It truly was always, hey, this is what we need to do for our clients to do the best, and this is how we're gonna have a positive working environment for people to come here. And that was just really the genesis of the growth, was focusing on a superior client service and really primarily too, just providing a great place to work for our team members.
So thinking of when you opened the office in 2004 versus where we are today, what does it look like? What are the big changes?
We've come a long way. So like when the company first started, I wouldn't even say like we were a company. Technically we were, but we were purely just professional service providers. It was myself and one other account manager. And that's along the way, people always gave me the advice of, hey, you need to start working on the business versus in the business. But that was always such a delicate balance because it's, well, if I'm not working, you know, in the business, like who is? So that's always the core, you know, function is, hey, serving your clients. So, over time, the company has evolved where now we have our leadership team and we're able to focus on the business itself. And that's been probably the biggest catalyst for growth, is eventually taking that next step to say, hey, we need to actually focus on creating a company and a great working environment, and then that really launched to the next level.
Well, I love that story, and you know, the whole grassroots and building it up the way you want to, which kind of leads to culture. And the reason I came to CMR was because of the culture. And Erik was, you know, one of the key folks in talking to me over the years before I came over. And, you know, how would you describe our culture, Erik, as a company?
Yeah, no, it's really developed over the years. I mean, Travis talked about the genesis, but for us, it really comes around the core values that we have. So that's passion, integrity, teamwork, hard work, and enjoyment. And I think it's so critical that we as leaders obviously instill in our staff how important those are. I think it's important that we recognize those that are putting those values in motion and encourage them to do the same with their staff. So over time, I think we've created this kind of organic, positive culture that really has empowered our staff to achieve their goals and be a part of the bigger picture goals, which that of the company. So I think we have a very positive culture for our employees. It empowers them to not only achieve the successes of our goals, but also to achieve their goals personally.
So tell me about that. I mean, I watch you do this every day, Erik. You do empower people. What does that look like with our employees?
Yeah, I mean, it's hard. I'm gonna be honest, you know, as a leader and everything and coming up, obviously you want to do everything yourself. And so, but you find over maturity and over time that if you truly want growth and you truly want to get your employees to the next level, you need to empower them. And part of that is making mistakes and watching them fail and having an ability to learn from that so that they can grow and develop and become future leaders of the organization. And I think that's where we're at now, is really trying to, you know, identify those that are actual leaders of our organization. You know, there's us three, but really this is a, we go back to one of our core values, teamwork, and bringing up those young leaders that we know one day are ultimately going to be those that are gonna, they're gonna follow them. They're gonna be the leaders of the organization.
Okay, good answer. Along that, those lines, how would you describe us being different from our competitors?
Yeah, that's a great question, because I mean, obviously that's the name of the game. So for us, I think it starts with customization and consultation. I think a lot of our competitors out there will come with a commercial. You know, we do X, Y, and Z. Here it is. It can be somewhat static. I think first and foremost, we listen. We sit down with these prospects. We talk to them. We understand and try to appreciate their specific needs. And with that, we come back with a customizable solution. So it may be one of 100 things that we offer, but that's really what's important to them today. And we partner with them and work with them in that capacity. You know, we're also, you know, considered what they say is a boutique agency. And so what comes with that is private ownership. And one of the great benefits of CMR is that we're so client-centric. We're so focused on always doing what's right by the client. We don't have stockholders. We're sitting here right now. So we always talk about our mission, our vision, and part of that is making sure that the client's needs come before our own. And so as the leadership and as the ownership of the agency, we're able to put that in motion and make sure that we're always client-centric and making sure that their needs are taken care of first and foremost.
In terms of risk, which is our business, I'd like to ask a question to you, Travis. What would you say the biggest and most important risk you've taken founding and running CMR and the rewards that it's reaped?
Well, outside of just leaving a comfortable situation and going into a startup where you're the last person to get paid, that was perhaps the biggest, like, personal risk at the time. And I think that's what holds a lot of people back from even venturing out to try and start up a company. But really, given that we are risk adverse, or we manage risk for a living, I don't necessarily want to categorize it as a risk, but it's more of just letting go of that professional service advice and trusting in your team to do the job. And that has helped in so many facets, because it helps us as an individual, either working on the building or from a business development standpoint. It helps us nurture those relationships and just and help the company grow. But then it really helps empowering our team, and it helps us attract the best people that do the best job. And just that, I don't want to, again, call it a risk. It's more of a transformation of, hey, I need to let go and trust in my team to do the job that they can do.
I was 100% certain you were going to say the biggest risk was taking me on board, and it was the biggest reward.
But I guess close second.
That was my next one.
Okay. Tell me a little bit about your favorite parts of this job, each of you.
For me, I would say, first and foremost, it's the people. You know, both internally and externally. You know, internally, it's pretty exciting to be able to work with such an awesome team, be a part of their developmental growth and helping them achieve their goals, and just working side by side. I mean, we talked about the culture, and I think we've been able to put together a pretty successful and positive culture, and so that's exciting. And then, you know, externally working with these clients, we're fortunate that, yes, while we work in insurance, which isn't exactly a glamorous industry, we do get to work with real estate owners and contractors and nonprofits, and getting to understand their business, how they go about it, what drives their success, what they're doing, what are their issues, what are their risks, and understanding that and working with them is actually exciting because we don't just stay in our little hole here as far as insurance. We're able to basically expand and learn a lot more industry. So it's pretty exciting from my vantage point.
How about you, Travis?
Yeah, I mean, I hate to just paraphrase Erik. That really is the truth. I mean, it is the insurance piece of the job is insurance. Like, no one sets out, wants to get into the insurance business. But it's super rewarding when you are giving professional advice to your clients and they're thanking you or they have a claims issue and you're helping them resolve them. I mean, you're protecting literally their number one asset that employs their family and everyone that works there. So it's something that's extremely important that a lot of, unfortunately, some people take for granted. But when you do have that client that really appreciates what you're doing and thanks you, that it's extremely rewarding. And at the same time, when we have team members that come over and give us compliments of, oh, I love all your procedures and policies here, and it's great to work here, like, to me, that's the best. It's hey, you know, we're really, you know, helping out and empowering our team members. And again, mm-hmm. that's the most rewarding part of the job.
Where do you see us in 5 years?
So, like I started off, while we do budgeting and have revenue goals and profit goals and growth goals, it's really just continuing to focus and execute on our core values and building a team that does have the integrity and passion and hard work and teamwork and enjoyable. And the reality is, if in 5 years from now we're the exact same, I'm not going to be disappointed, but at the same time, I know that's not gonna happen because just our message is resonating well with the people in the insurance community, which helps us recruit and just with attracting clients. So ideally, I would like to see us expand maybe into some more industries and some more practice groups of line of business specialization. But the key is versus not having to make decisions to hit revenue goals and growth goals because we're private and we don't have any equity or stockholders to adhere to, we can make decisions that are truly best for our team and for our clients.
I love that answer. I think that is CMR's differentiator. You know, I come from a big company background and where you manage on top line, and to have this organic approach to growth and putting employees and clients first is just an amazing way to run your business, and it really just generates a great culture. I guess my last question, and probably the most important question, is do you guys wish you went to University of San Diego instead of San Diego State? Can you just admit that right now?
Not at all. That's probably the best decision I made was going to San Diego State. Yes. Now knowing you and what product comes from there, I'm very happy with my decision.
That is the secret to our success. San Diego
State. I'm obviously a USD alum. They went to San Diego State, so it's pretty fun. Well, thank you. Thank you for your time today.
Yeah,
please check us out on our website, and thanks for watching.